How do you know if there are rogue devices using your network? In other words, an example would be your neighbor is using your Wi-Fi without your permission. How do you discover the devices in your network? How do you protect your network from rogue devices by blocking them as an example? How do you check what's happening on your network and check how healthy your network is? How do you test for security vulnerabilities in your network? Well, one option is to use the Fing app. Now, some people who watch my videos are really technical. You may want to use Nmap as an example to scan for devices in your network. You might even want to write Python scripts to block devices from your network or do other things. But if you want an easy solution that runs on your phone as an example or on a laptop or is installed as a 24 monitoring agent on a Raspberry Pi, then Fing is a great solution. A Raspberry Pi like this could be deployed at your mother's home network or grandmother's home network as an example, so that it's easier for you to help them manage their network. You'll be able to manage it remotely and see what's going on as an example. A lot of small business owners as an example don't have the time or technical expertise to manage their networks, so this is an easy solution for those types of users as well. If you see devices like this in your network, you probably have a problem unless you are a technical person. I've previously recorded shorts about the Fing app, and a lot of people have requested that I create a long-form video showing a bunch of the features available with Fing and perhaps why you would want to use it. But notice here, I've got the Fing app running on this laptop. It's already told me that I had connectivity issues 30 minutes ago, but now the network looks good. If I go to devices, I can see various devices in my test network here. If you see something like Kali Linux or a virtual machine and you haven't set it up, investigate it, find out what's going on. So as an example here, it's picked up that there's a Kali Linux machine running on our network. It tells us the IP address, MAC address, other information about the device. And notice what we can do here. We could, as an example, find open ports on that device. We could limit internet time of that device or simply block it from our network. Now with Fing, you can set it up to automatically block all new devices or allow devices and then you manually block them. So that's a choice that you need to make. Do you want to automatically block any new devices that connect to your network so that only specific devices that you permit are allowed? Or you could just manually block certain devices if you wanted to. But as an example, on this Kali Linux machine, if I open up a web browser and go to davidbomble.com as an example, notice the website displays. So I have internet connectivity from this device, but back in the Fing app, in this example, I'm running Fing on the laptop and I'm controlling the network from the laptop. You could do stuff from your phone if you want to. Just as a caveat, there are some restrictions in what you can do on the phone. You have more power when you use the desktop app. As an example, let's block this Kali device. So do you want to prevent Kali from accessing your network? So I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to block it. So back on devices now, notice this device has been blocked. We can see the hand over there. So back on the Kali machine, if I try and go to davidbomble.com, notice I have no internet access at the moment. If I open up a command prompt and try and ping google.com, that is failing. So we can't get to the site, davidbomble.com. And just to make the point, I'll go to Google. Notice Google is also timing out. And notice we can't ping google.com. So pings are failing. Ping, if you don't know, is an easy way to test connectivity. That's failing. My web browser can't access the internet. We have successfully blocked this device from getting to the internet. Notice Google can't be found. Now, if you want to unblock a device, you can simply click on that device and unblock the network access. So unblock the device. Okay, going back to devices, notice the Kali device is no longer blocked. And if I connect back to the device itself and try to go to Google, notice we can get access to google.com and we can get access to davidbomble.com. So device has been permitted back onto the network. Now in the real world, it's very unlikely that you're going to allow a device like this onto your network. I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes. In the real world, you're probably going to be blocking other types of devices like phones. Now, Fing has a lot of options. Another option is to determine open ports on the device. So in this example, let's scan the ports on this Raspberry Pi, which is running the Fing agent. So you can see IP address again of the device, MAC address, other information. but let's focus on finding open ports. Okay, so as an example there, you can see that the SSH port, port 22, is open on the Raspberry Pi. So I could, as an example, SSH to the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. So I'll use PuTTY, which is an application in Windows that allows me to SSH to the device. I'll accept the public key and I'm asked to log in. So I can specify my username, let's say David, and my password, and I can log in. As you can see there, we are logged into the Raspberry Pi. If you don't know what PuTTY is, you don't know what SSH is, don't worry about it. Point is that you can scan for open ports on a device in your network and find out if ports have been opened that shouldn't be opened. Okay, so now let's test which ports are open on this little Wi-Fi router in our test network. So I'll click on the router and click find open ports. Notice we see something similar, as well as port 20,001. Now you could, if you like, scan more ports. So you could scan 65,000 ports if you wanted to. So notice it's scanning ports 65,535. It's found these ports open. So 20,001, 1900, 443, and 80. So HTTP, HTTPS, UPnP, which could be a problem, universal plug and play, and port 20,001. Now here are a lot of security options, including telling us that there's a moderate vulnerability detected. If I click on see result, you can see that this TP-Link router, IP address 192.168.0.1, allows unchecked NAT PMP port forwarding. So applications on your network can expose your devices without control. This can be a big problem because if your devices on your local network automatically open up ports on your router, hackers can then go through your router and attack those devices or leverage those devices to attack your home network. This website, Shodan, allows people to discover everything on the internet. So it allows people like hackers and security researchers to find internet-connected devices, including IP cameras and other types of devices. So unless you have a very specific reason to allow this option on your router, you're going to want to turn it off. So if I click on web interface, that's going to take me to my router's interface and allow me to log in and turn off that option. So I'll log into the router, and if I go to advanced, NAT forwarding, UPnP, or universal plug and play, I could disable this option. So again, this allows devices on your local network to dynamically open ports for applications such as multiplayer gaming and real-time communications. Be careful with this option. Devices, again, on your local network could automatically open up ports on your router, which can open up holes, which can be a security vulnerability. So I'll click refresh here to see what's happened. Notice that no vulnerability is now detected because we've disabled that option on the router. So back in security, we are told about unconfirmed devices. This is where you can confirm, in other words, permit devices onto your network. So confirm that they are valid devices. You could enable notifications when a new device joins your network, and you could decide to automatically block new devices from accessing your network. This will mean that any new device is automatically blocked when it joins your network. So I'm going to get this phone to connect to the network. Notice now we're told new device blocked, Pixel 8 Pro, and the device is automatically blocked. So notice now if I try and go to YouTube, it's not allowing me to go to that website. If I try and go to Amazon as an example, I can't get onto the network because this device is automatically blocked. Now if I go and unblock the device, so I'll resume it, so unblock this device. Notice it's now online, and hopefully I'll be able to go to various websites. So there you go, I can go to amazon.co.uk. Notice you also see here that this device is blocked. So you can automatically set up the Fing agent running on your Raspberry Pi or your Fing application on your computer to block devices from joining your network. The advantage of running a Fing agent like this is that you get 24/7 monitoring. In a separate video, which I've linked below, I show you how to set up agents on various devices, including a Raspberry Pi, as well as a NAS, as well as a Docker container. Notice here, no new camera is found. What happens if someone does connect a camera to our network or another rogue device? Can you discover cameras in your network? So in this example, I've got an IP camera, which I'll power on and plug into the network. This camera is using a wired connection, but the same thing would apply to a wireless device as I've demonstrated with the blocking of this phone. But let's say I plug in that camera. Takes it a while to boot up and get ready. but it's now joining the network. Okay, notice there, new device blocked. This camera is on the network and has been blocked. So device was automatically blocked from joining our network. So we've got a notification of that. Under notifications here, we can see that, and we can see that it's an IP camera. So under security, we'll be able to see one unconfirmed device. We can confirm that device so that we tell Fing that it's a device that we recognize. And notice at the bottom here, it's picked up that there's an unknown camera in our network. So in the results here, we can see unknown camera has been discovered. So Fing can discover various devices in your network. Notice here we see a Raspberry Pi, here we see a router, here we see a whole bunch of phones, but it can also discover IP cameras and other devices. And then you can decide what to do with those devices, automatically block them or permit them and deny only the devices that you manually want to deny. It's really up to you. There are also a bunch of tools available in Fing that you can use, including speed tests, where you can check the download speed and upload speed of your internet connection, and also the delay, jitter, and other options on your network. As you can see here, this test network has a terrible download speed and upload speed, so not great. Hopefully yours will be better than what we're seeing here. You can also detect outages. Notice this option, find hidden cameras. This camera was blocked, but you could use that option to find various hidden cameras on your network. They also have tools such as ping and traceroute. Ping allows you to test connectivity to a destination. So make sure that you have IP connectivity, and then you can run that ping test for a certain amount of time and then get information such as the packet loss, delay, and so forth. As you can see here, this network has a lot of problems currently. Big issues in the network at the moment. 90% packet loss is not a great thing. We could also use traceroute, which allows us to see the path to a destination. You could scan for Wi-Fi networks. You could do a MAC address lookup if you're not sure about a specific MAC address that you're seeing in your network, and various other options to allow you to troubleshoot your network. Okay, so a lot of options available with Fing. You could run it as an app on your phone. You could run it as a desktop app. You could run it as an agent on your Raspberry Pi or on a NAS or a Docker container as an example. The installation of the Fing app is actually very simple. So what I'll do is close it here, and notice it's still running when you do that. So you've got to exit it manually. But all you need to do is search for Fing download, and then you can download the app. So I'm going to choose the first option in Google. So I'm going to get Fing desktop for Windows. You could obviously choose Mac OS if you preferred. So I'll click on get for Windows. Click save to save that to my hard drive. Once it downloads, you simply need to double click on the executable and then say yes to allow it to make changes. Read through the license agreement and then click agree if you agree to it. You'd have to agree to the license agreement to install the software. And as you can see there, the software is now being installed. Okay, so once it's installed, click finish to run the application. Now mine automatically logged in because I installed it previously. What you would have to do is log in to the Fing application to use the software. But installation is fairly simple. Again, I show you in a different video how to install the Fing agent on a Raspberry Pi and other devices. Simple installation on a computer. Installation on a phone is just like a typical app. So you go to the Play Store and then search for the Fing app. So I'll search for Fing here. In my example, it's installed, but you would simply click install to install it. I really want to thank Fing for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.